Hello boys and girls, today we are going to learn how to adjust the front side pickup height, also known as the neck pickup to some, on a Squier Telecaster. First, we will need a tool. Do not use this. Now, while true, on a drill like this, you can set the torque to its lowest setting. This is not, and I do have a rather crappy bit on this. Do not use this. This is way too heavy. And even though you can go real slow with it, there is just too much opportunity to go off the screw by mistake and damage the body. Don't use this. Now you might be thinking, what about one of the smaller ones like this? Don't use this either. There is no torque control on this, and again you run into the same problem of sliding off the screw and damaging the body, and that would be bad. I mean, on this one, I can even, if I can actually do it, there we go. Even when you have it like this, even though it's lightweight, doesn't matter. Don't use this. What you do want to use is one of these. Just the regular manual screwdriver, either a larger one or a smaller one. The smaller one is actually the best to use because there is the least likely opportunity to slide off the pick guard and damage, and plus you can actually hold it easier where you hold this and then this part turns where you can palm it on top. So, first step, we take off the pick guard. No, we do not have to remove the strings, just take off the guard. Now, while we are doing this, see how easy this is? Okay. So I'm going to take these screws and put them to the side. And so you can pinch down here and turn so that there is no danger of accidentally hitting the body. In addition, you can also two-hand it when you're actually going to remove the screws. So we put it into the hole, grab, turn. Real simple. Now, this is a traditional vintage style front side pickup mount. And you'll notice that not all Telecasters are like that. Some of them, like the American Standard, do have screw adjustments on the outside of the guard. That was something that was put in later when enough players complained about it. But on traditional designs, pick guard designs like this one, they are not on the outside and are in fact under the guard. You'll notice that there is a half circle break where the for the control plate here. This is usually where the pick guard sticks, and it will also stick around the neck. What we're going to do is take off the guard and slide it out of the way. Alright, we got the back. There we go. Now, the strings are still on it, and I am going to take it and simply slide it away. Here's a screw here. Here's a screw there. We want to raise the pickup. We would turn one of these screws this way, counterclockwise, that will raise the pickup. If we turn it this way, that will lower the pickup. Now, can you play this guitar with the pick guard off so you can test for tone and whether your strings are hitting the pickup? Yes, we can plug it in right now and do that if we wanted to. Don't have to, because it should be self-explanatory, but we can. Now, as far as how high, if you have absolutely no idea how high the pickup should go, you say, how high should my pickup go? This is a wide source of debate, but generally speaking, if you have no clue, set the height of the pickup to the height of the fretboard. You do that, that will keep strings from hitting it. It will promote even volume. If you want to tilt the pickup, like make this side lower and this side higher, you can if you want to. That's up to you. On a final note, before we put the pick guard on, you'll notice that there is a little bit of movement to this pickup. That's totally normal. Okay, at this point we're going to put the guard back on. So again, now I like to do it from bottom to top of body. And again, remember, this is the tough part. We'll get back to that in a second. So slide back under the strings and then press down. And this is the most important part. Get that half circle around that control plate. Make sure it's down as well as you can get it. If it's not flush, that's okay. The screws will make it flush. Now we're going to screw the guard back in. I suggest doing these two first, and then these two, and then the rest, because this is the most important point, and this is the second most important point in order to keep the guard properly screwed down to the body. So I'm going to start with this one. I'm going to hold my screw like this, guide it in, and start turning. Actually, I should hold that. How tight should you put your screw? Hand tight. You don't have to put it super tight. Now, for those of you with basswood body guitars, regardless if it's a Telecaster or a Stratocaster or whatever it is, here's a tip for you. Basswood is a really soft wood, and it is really easy to strip the hole on a basswood wood guitar. Don't over-tighten, because you can really easily strip that screw hole on basswood. Now, this is a Squier Affinity, so this is an alder body, which has a little more hardness, not density, but hardness to it. On even harder woods, like swamp ash, I think is one of them, the screw will be a little harder to turn usually, but that's just the nature of the wood density. Okay, so we did this one, and this one, and now we just go around and do the rest. I go from top to bottom just to make it easy. So there's that one. And again, I am only going hand tight. It's not like these screws are going to fall out. You basically want it tight enough so that the guard does not rattle. That's the general rule of thumb. And we're almost done. There we go. And last one. There we go. We are done. So, again, we took it off, we adjusted, put it to the height of the fretboard. That's what I do anyway. These two screws go back on first, then these two, then 1, 2, 3, 4. We're finished, and there you go. Done and done.